Hello students, this video is on carboxylic acids and its derivatives. Question number 1. An ester A, C4HAO2 on treatment with excess methyl magnesium chloride, methyl CH3, magnesium Mg chloride, Grignard reagent. So CH3 minus MgCl positive part. Followed by acidification gives alcohol B as the sole organic product. Only one product is formed. Alcohol B on oxidation with sodium hypochloride followed by acidification gives acetic acid. Therefore, ester A is. The sodium hypochloride is formed by reaction between chlorine and sodium hydroxide. And this reagent is a haloform reagent. Now you know that for haloform reaction, compound must contain R, CO and CH3. There must be methyl keto compound. During the reaction, what happens is that it becomes R, COONE, sodium salt carboxylic acid, and CH3 becomes CHX3 in general, haloform. Okay. So it is also a kind of oxidation. That means ketones can be oxidized to give carboxylic acid, right? Now we have tried with the option A. Okay, let me take option A. We have got a formic acid, HCOOH formic acid. Now the ester of that one, it is a formate ester. Okay, formate ester. Now you make react with methyl magnesium chloride. CH3 minus MgCl, Grignard reagent. We are going to make the excess of this one. You know that nucleophile CH3 minus easily attacks the carbonyl carbon, and this is a leaving group. It goes out. On acidification, we get alcohol form. That is, we are going to get HC double bond O and CH3 now. Okay, plus after acidification we get OH alcohol, then CH, then there are two CH3s on that carbon atom. Excess, again there is a carbonyl carbon, further reacts with the Grignard reagent, CH3 minus MgBCl, plus the nucleophile CH3 minus attacks the carbon atom. There is no leaving group. CH3 cannot be a leaving group. Hydrogen cannot go out. So, but it can finally form now O minus, that will take now acidic hydrogen. So after acidification, finally we get HCOH, then the Grignard reagent CH3 and one more CH3. Now see here, this product, okay, and this product, they are same. We get the same product. That's why they are mentioned here, sole organic product. Okay. Now we'll carry out the haloform reaction. Now haloform reaction, we know that it is a reaction of the methyl keto compound. Even alcohols also. For example, CH3CHOH and R. Even this kind of alcohols can also answer the haloform reaction, because the haloform reagent is a oxidizing agent. So it can oxidize the alcohol, given alcohol, into the methyl keto compound and some R group. Remember, the compound must contain CH3, CHOH group. Okay. And that is finally becomes the methyl keto compound. Now in this example, we have got CH3, then CHOH and CH3. This is the one product form, right? This is the secondary alcohol. This is the 2-propanol. 2-propanol. And this on oxidation in the presence of haloform reagent. Okay, that is a sodium hypochlorite. First getting oxidized to give corresponding keto compound. Corresponding keto compound. Remember, secondary alcohols are converted into or oxidized to give ketones. And now this again undergoes oxidation in the presence of sodium hypochlorite. So what will happen? The COCH3 bond breaks. So one part is the sodium salt of the carboxylic acid, and second one will be the haloform. In this case, it is the chloroform, right? Now, this sodium salt of the acetic acid on acidification gives CH3COOH, which is acetic acid now, which is acetic acid. So we'll go back to the question now. In the question, they mention gives acetic acid, okay? Therefore, answer is option number A. Suppose A was not the answer, we could have tried for B, C, and D. Also remember, okay, with the Grignard reagent, aldehyde gives, with the Grignard reagent, aldehyde gives the primary alcohol, okay? Now, there are different types of the aldehydes, okay? So formaldehyde can give primary alcohol. All other aldehyde gives secondary alcohol. And always ketones give rise to tertiary alcohol. Okay. This is with respect to aldehydes, ketones, and Grignard reagent. Now if I take formyl ester gives secondary alcohol, and other esters gives the tertiary alcohol. Based on this also we can solve the problem, okay, right? Now therefore, for this question, what is the answer? Is option number A, right? Question number two. In the reaction, they are given acetic acid, carboxylic acid. Lithium aluminum hydride is a strong reducing agent. Then I2 sodium hydroxide corresponds to the iodoform reaction. And silver dust, okay, that we'll see later what is the B product we are going to get, right? Now, acetic acid is the carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid in the presence of strong reducing agent, that is a lithium aluminum hydride, gives directly the primary alcohol, and the corresponding primary alcohol is, that is a CH3. Number of carbon atom remain the same. Add hydrogen, remove oxygen, primary alcohol. Now this primary alcohol is here. It is made to react with the iodine and sodium hydroxide. This is the haloform reaction, that is the iodoform reaction in this case. So this reagent is the oxidizing agent. Now primary alcohol are oxidized to give aldehydes. They can give rise to aldehydes. Now write on the corresponding aldehyde with the same number of carbon atom, that is the CH3CHO. So I'll be writing the structure as CH3C double bond OH. Again, the same reagent, that is the I2 and sodium hydroxide reacts with this. Okay. Now we have got methyl keto compound. Methyl keto compound undergoes, okay, the iodoform reaction. So we get now the iodoform CHI3, and this is a yellow precipitate. And other part become the sodium salt of the carboxylic acid. Only one carbon atom is there. But we get now here sodium salt of the formic acid, right? Formic acid. Now, let this be B now. B reacts with this silver dust, right? So what I'll do now, I'm going to write the reaction with the iodoform. So carbon attached to the hydrogen, then iodine, three number iodine. I will write one more molecule. H, C, H, I, I, and iodine, I'll treat with the silver. Okay. So silver can take up all these six iodine atoms. Therefore, six silver iodide is formed. Six silver iodide is formed. Okay. So we'll get six moles of silver iodide, the precipitate. Okay. Then we are left with the HC and HC. Okay. On the other molecule. So we need to introduce a triple bond between them. That means it is a C2H2, which is nothing but ethyne, Okay. So therefore, for this question, the final product C is option number C, right? That is a C2H2, that is the ethyne. And ethyne is also known as the acetylene, right? Next question, compound C in the above reaction sequences. Now see carefully that given reactant contains ester here. There are two ester groups. Then there is an ether group here, OCH3. It is hydrolyzed, hydroxylamine. You know the hydroxylamine reacts with the keto compounds, aldehydes or ketone. Then concentrated sulfuric acid generally act as the dehydrating agent. And finally, it is acidified. So let me take the given reactant. Let me write down its structural formula. The cyclohexane ring, then C, double bond O, O, ET stand for C2H5, ethyl group. It is the ethyl group. Other side also the same thing. C, double bond O, O, and C2H5 it is. Then there are ether linkages to a number, OCH3, okay? Then OCH3, correct? Yeah. First step, hydrolysis. During hydrolysis, okay, the ester breaks into two parts. So hydrolysis, I introduce H plus and OH minus, okay? Here also for the ester thing, right? And for the ethers also, let me write on H plus and OH minus. So the product obtained here is, we get now, there are two OH groups. Okay, on the same carbon atom, then COOH and then COOH, right? Now this is heated. When heated, what will happen? Now, whenever there are two OH groups on the same carbon atom, it is unstable, always loses a water molecule. So it becomes now keto compound. It becomes keto compound on this molecule. Then we have got COOH, COOH. Okay. Now, with respect to the functional group, carbon atom, alpha carbon, beta carbon, this side also, alpha carbon, beta carbon. Whenever there is a beta keto carboxylic acid, easily decarboxylation takes place, a removal of carbon dioxide takes place. Okay, to give the product, this one cyclohexane, we have got cyclohexane, then cyclohexanone. Remove those CO2 groups, introduce hydrogen. So we'll get this product, which is nothing but cyclohexanone. This will be cyclohexanone, right? So on heating, you will get cyclohexanone. That is product A. Okay, product A. Then treat the hydroxylamine. A compound is treated with the hydroxylamine. You know that hydroxylamines react with the either aldehydes or ketones. Okay, so condensation reaction, removal of water takes place, minus water, and gives the oxime as the product. Okay, we'll get oxime as the product, oxime. So we'll get double bond NOH, oxime product. This is compound B, right? This will be compound B. then treated with the concentrated sulfuric acid and hydrolyzed acid hydrolysis. Okay, now here this oxime is treated with first step concentrated sulfuric acid, followed by second one acid hydrolyzed. I will not go into the details of the mechanism, but I'll let you know what this reaction is. This is known as a special reaction for the Beckmann reagent rearrangement or Beckmann reaction. Okay, so I'll be writing the final product like this. Okay, now we have got a 6-membered ring here, it will become 7-membered ring. So we'll be having double bond O, carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4, carbon number 5, carbon number 6, and nitrogen comes there in the form of NH. It is like a C double bond O NH, like it is amide. Now this is cyclic. Generally, this type of compounds are called the lactones. These are called lactones. Now let me explain that Beckmann reaction using simple reactions. Okay, let me take like this. Suppose I have got R1, C double bond O, then say R2 group. Okay. Now, what will happen in the presence of hydroxylamine? In the presence of hydroxylamine, we get oxime R1C double bond NOH. Then it is R2. And then the rearrangement takes place on acid hydrolysis. Okay. Very typical reaction, tricky reaction it is. So I'll be writing the final product like this: R1C double bond NH and R2. Okay. This kind of reaction is Beckmann reaction. Therefore, for this question, answer is option number B. Okay. So option number B will get, right? Question number 4. What is the final product of the following reaction? Hex-3-inyl. Okay. Alkynal it is. Alkene, alkyne, carbon-carbon triple bond. Aldehyde is there. Okay. Sodium borohydrate, reducing agent, PBr3, magnesium ether for Grignard reaction and CO2, right. Let me write down X3-inyl, that is the carbon number 6, X6 carbonate, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. On third carbon atom, let it be carbon number 1, on third carbon atom, triple bond comes and R stand for aldehyde, that means the last carbon in the form of aldehyde group. Okay. Now I've written only the skeleton part. Now this is allowed to react to the sodium borohydride. Sodium borohydride is a reducing agent. It's a mild reducing agent. Can react with the aldehydes and ketones only. Therefore, aldehydes are reduced to primary alcohol. It gives primary alcohol. Okay. So single bond C, triple bond C, single bond C, then convert that into the primary alcohol, right? We get primary alcohol. Then followed by PBr3, like PCl3 and PCl5 type of reaction, wherein OH group is replaced by the halogen. Okay. So I'll get a single bond, triple bond, then single bond, then CH2Br will get. Okay. So it is in the form of alkyl bromide. Okay. The last part. Then treat with the magnesium metal. Magnesium, right? This is like alkyl halide. Reacts with the magnesium to form Grignard reagent RMgBr. So we'll get now C, single bond C, triple bond C, single bond C, CH2MgBr. So alkyl part or alkenyl part negatively charged. Okay, R part is negatively charged. Remaining part is positively charged. Then treat with the carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide, C double bond O, double bond O. So we have now nucleophile can attack the carbon atom. Then Okay. On acidification, what will happen? The bond will take up, negative charge will take up the positive H plus ion, proton. Therefore, finally, we'll get CCC. Triple bond C, single bond C, then a CH2 and a COOH. When Grignard reagents are treated with the carbon dioxide, we get finally the carboxylic acids. So, how many carbon atoms are there? Let me write like this. Carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4, carbon number 5, carbon number 6, and carbon number 7. So, let me start with the COOH, carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4, carbon number 5. Carbon number 5 and 4 and 5 has got a triple bond, carbon number 6 and carbon number 7. Okay. Now you have to identify where is that compound. Okay. The compound is, you can see here, carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4, carbon number 5, carbon number 6, and carbon number 7. So what is the answer? Answer is option number D. And moreover, only one option has got carbon-carbon triple bond. Right? Yeah. So answer is option number D. Question number 5. Which of the following on treatment with hot concentrated acidified potassium permanganate strong oxidizing agent? Remember, this is strong oxidizing agent gives 2-methylhexane 1,6 dioic acid as the only organic product. Okay. Remember, whenever there is a carbon-carbon double bond, let me write in general R is CH and H and R here. The carbon-carbon double bond breaks completely. So it will give finally the carboxylic acid. That is RCOOH. Other part also become RCOOH. Okay. Now let me take option number A here. Okay. Since I don't know what is the answer directly, I can take option number A. Right. So let me write cyclohexene and here there is a CH3 group. Okay. Now I'll be breaking this group. So now the product will be, for this product will be, cyclohexane will break up. So I have to introduce now the carboxylic group, the double bond OH, okay, at the double bond. Then there is a methyl group, right? Now let me number the carbon atom. Carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4, carbon number 5, carbon number 6. This molecule is a 3-methyl. This is a 3-methyl, okay, 3-methyl. It is a 3-methyl 1,6 dioic acid. This is not the required product for us. Now, see the similar structure. See the similar structure in the option. Option C we can try. Right? Option C we can try. So let me go for option C now. So we have got a cyclohexene. Then there's a CH3. Break the molecule into two parts. So we'll get now like this. Okay. So this will be C double bond OH. At the double bond, bond breaks. The double bond breaks completely. Then here, C double bond OH. Number the carbon atom so that the methyl group gets the lower number. Carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4, carbon number 5, and carbon number 6. Now this is known as the 2-methylhexane 1,6 dioic acid, right? Therefore, answer is option number C, correct? Question number 6. The total number of carboxylic acid groups in the product P is. This is a numerical type question. Okay. So we can see in the compound given, double bond is there. Then there are two keto compounds. And there is a like ester derivatives are there. COO types are there, right? Now, first one is hydrolysis, followed by the ozonolysis. For ozonolysis, require carbon-carbon double bond, and hydrogen peroxide is an oxidizing agent, right? So, I'll carry out now first hydrolysis, then followed by heating, right? So let me write down the structure as it is. So we have got cyclohexene, then second ring, dione, double bond O, and double bond O we have got. Then we have got double bond O, then O, cyclic compound. Now, carry out acid hydrolysis, okay? Now, carbonyl carbon, okay? I will break it into two parts, okay? So I write H here, H plus here, and OH minus here, OH minus. So we'll be getting product like this, cyclohexene, then dione on the second molecule, second ring, and then it becomes a COOH, correct? And this side also COOH. Now, with respect to the carbon atom, alpha carbon, beta carbon. So this is alpha carbon, beta carbon. Recall, whenever compound has got beta keto carboxylic acid, beta keto carboxylic acid, on heating, they undergo decarboxylation, remove this carbon dioxide. So I'll get now product, okay, with only two rings, double bond here, then we'll have the double bond O here and double bond O here, and these positions are occupied by now hydrogen instead of carbon atom, right? This is the product obtained on heating. Now it is then treated with ozone. Now during ozonolysis, carbon-carbon bond breaks, then you have to introduce oxygen atoms, okay? Oxygen atom. Simple alkene will give aldehyde groups. So we'll break the molecule. So we'll get now. So there is a cyclic compound with the dione like this, right? Then a compound, correct? A bond breaks here. So double bond was there. Double bond was there. Double bond becomes a keto compound and one hydrogen is attached. Okay. We get aldehyde here. We get one aldehyde. Correct? Yeah. Now, this aldehyde is further oxidized by hydrogen peroxide and undergoes oxidation. Aldehydes on oxidation gives next intermediate product, that is carboxylic acid. So we get now, okay, the ring with the double bond O. Then we have got COOH. So we have now the aldehyde getting oxidized to give carboxylic acid. Question is, total number of carboxylic acid groups in the product. So how many carboxylic acid groups are there? Two are there. Therefore, so we'll be writing the answer like 2.00. Okay? Since it is an integer type question. Right? If you are not subscribed to RD Chemistry, please do subscribe, like and share the videos. Thank you.